Welcome to my channel Involve Innovation. In this video, we are going to see how to install Raspbian Stretch OS in the Raspberry Pi 3 and possibly solve all the issues which you might face during this installation process. First, take a micro SD card. I suggest using at least class 10 SD card. Class denotes the speed of data transfer. Mount the SD card in the card reader. Now, insert the card reader in the card reader slot in your laptop. First, we need to format the memory card. To format the memory card, I am going to use SD card formatter. To download SD card formatter, go to the website sdcard.org. Click Downloads and I am going to download the Windows version of SD card formatter. In the SD card formatter section, click SD card formatter for Windows download. Scroll down and accept the license agreement. Once you click the accept, the SD card formatter.exe will start downloading. Now we can able to see the exe is getting downloaded. Now the SD card formatter got downloaded. Now navigate to the downloaded folder and right click the SD card formatter.exe and select run as administrator. Make sure you are running all the exe file as administrator. Click yes. Now click next. Accept the license agreement. Then click next. If you want to change the folder where this SD card formatter need to be installed, you can do so by clicking change button. I don't want to change the default folder, so I am clicking next. Click install. By default, launcher program will be checked. Keep it checked and click finish. Now this will open the SD card formatter. Now click this PC in the left navigation and make note of the SD card drive name. In my case, it is H drive. Make sure H is selected in the select card drop down and select the quick format radio button and enter the volume label name as Raspberry Pi. Now click format. Click S in the warning box. This will format the SD card and make it ready for Raspbian OS to be installed. Now click OK in the success alert box. Now our SD card got formatted. Now we need to download the Raspbian OS. As of today's date, the latest Raspbian version is Stretch. This process will be same for any Raspbian OS version. To download Raspbian OS, navigate to the website raspberrypi.org. Click download in the top navigation bar and click Raspbian. Now click download zip in the Raspbian Stretch with desktop. This will start downloading Raspbian OS. Make sure you have some unzipping tool in your system. I am using 7-zip, which is freeware. You can download the 7-zip from the website 7-zip.org. Now Raspbian OS got downloaded. Now navigate to the downloaded folder, then right click the zip and click extract here. Click next. This will start unzipping the Raspbian OS. Now we can see a new folder. Inside that we can see the Raspbian OS image file. Now we need to download the disk imager. This will write the Raspbian OS in the SD card. To download the disk imager, click the link installation guide in the Raspbian download page. Scroll down and click Windows. In this page, click the SourceForge project page link, which will take us to Win32 disk imager SourceForge page. Click download. This will start the countdown. Once the countdown completes, this will automatically initiate the Win32 disk imager download. Now the Win32 disk imager got downloaded. Now open the folder where the Win32 disk imager got downloaded. and right click the Win32 disk imager .exe and select run as administrator. Click yes. Accept the license agreement and click next. Change the installation folder if you wish. I don't want to change the default installation folder, so I am clicking next. Click next. Click next. Now click install. Once installation done, uncheck the view readme.txt and click finish. This will open the Win32 disk imager. Make sure the S3 guard drive got selected in the device dropdown. Now copy the path where the Raspbian OS image got extracted and paste it in the image file text box. Now click the folder icon, select the image file and click open. Now make sure everything is correct, including the drive name. Click right. Now press yes in the warning alert box. This will write the Raspbian OS in the SD card. Now the write is successful. Click OK. Now close the Win32 disk imager. Now we need to open Network and Sharing Center. To open Network and Sharing Center, search Network Status. Then click Ethernet in the left navigation pane and click Network and Sharing Center. Keep it open. We will use it later. Now we need to download PuTTY. To download PuTTY, go to the website putty.org. Click the link here. Download putty.exe 64-bit. My system is 64-bit architecture, so I am downloading 64-bit version. If you want to know what is your architecture, click my video tutorial to find the system's architecture, the link of which I have gave in the description. Next, we need to download the Xming server. To download Xming server, search Xming in the Google. Click the first SourceForge link of Xming. Click download. Now the download will start. Now we downloaded both PuTTY and Xming X server for Windows. Now we need to go to the folder where the Xming server got downloaded. Right click the exe and select run as administrator. Click next. Click next. I am going to continue with the default options. Click next. Click next. Next. Click install. Uncheck the launch Xming and click finish. Now it's time to get started with Raspberry Pi. Take the Raspberry Pi, insert the SD card. The card reader will be present in the back side of the Raspberry Pi. Make sure you are inserting the SD card before connecting the power source. The Raspberry Pi is a delicate device, so give utmost care when you are inserting memory card or external peripherals into the Raspberry Pi. Now give the power source to the Raspberry Pi. The light will glow once the power source is plugged in. Now plug in one side of Ethernet cable to the Raspberry Pi. Plug another side of Ethernet cable to the laptop. Now the Ethernet cable light will glow, and in the Network and Sharing Center, we can able to see an unidentified network of connection type Ethernet cable. We need to share our laptop internet connection. This is very important step. Click the system's main internet connection and click Properties. Click the Sharing tab. Check allow other network users to connect through this computer's network connection, and also check allow other network users to control or to disable the shared internet connection. Make sure you check both this option. Click OK, then click close. Now open the Xming server. Once opened, it will be started and it will be minimized in the taskbar tray. Now start the putty.exe as administrator. Type hostname as raspberrypi.msHome.net and port must be 22. Select connection type as SSH and navigate to SSH in the left navigation pane. Expand SSH and click X11. Check X11 forwarding. X display location as localhost : 0. X11 authentication protocol is MIT Magic Cookie 1. Now go back to the session and in the saved session type raspberry and click save button. Now this session and configuration details will be saved in the putty. If you reopen the putty, we no longer need to give the configuration again. Just select this session and click the load button. This will automatically get loaded and you can click open to open this session. Now click open. Many who are watching this tutorial might get connected to the Raspberry Pi at this moment. If you got connected, I'm happy. Skip to the end of this tutorial where I will be entering the commands in the putty terminal. If not, follow along with me. We will rectify the different connection issues. In our case, we got network error, connection timed out. Now reopen the putty as administrator and check the host name, whether it is correct. Check for the typos. Open the command prompt and enter the command ping raspberrypi.mshome.net. If you are getting a request timeout, then there is no host name like raspberrypi.mshome.net in your system. Now open the network and sharing and open the main internet connection and check whether both the options are checked in the sharing tab. If it is checked already, unmount the SD card from the Raspberry Pi and insert it in the laptop card reader slot. Now navigate to the SD card drive and create a new file named SSH. Right click, create new text document and rename it to SSH without any extension. Press yes in the warning rename tab. Now eject the card reader and insert it to the Raspberry Pi and plug the power source. Plug in Ethernet cable into the Raspberry Pi and to your laptop. Now open the network and sharing tab and click the Raspberry Pi Ethernet connection. Click properties. Now double click Internet Protocol version 4 and make note of the IP address. In my system it is 192.168.137.1. Open browser, go to the advanced. Now we need to download advanced IP scanner. This will scan the IPs which are active in your system. To download advanced IP scanner, open the browser and go to advancedipscanner.com and click download. It will download the advanced IP scanner.exe. Now open the exe file, select English and press OK. I don't want to install, I just want to scan, so I select run and click next. Accept the license agreement and click next. It will open the advanced IP scanner. Now open the notepad where you noted your Raspberry Pi's IP address. Enter the IP address. Remove all the digits after last full stop. Add 0 and enter hyphen and paste the IP address again. And remove all the digits after full stop and enter 254. That means it will check all the IP which starts with 192.168.137 from the range 0 to 254. Click scan. Now in the manufacturers, look for Raspberry Pi Foundation or any name with Raspberry in it. If you find anything, copy that name or IP and paste it in the putty's host name and open that session. That will resolve the issue for some people. If you don't find any name or manufacturer name with raspberry in it, like me, then follow along with me. The final step which I am going to do will resolve this problem. Open Network and Sharing Center and click the Raspberry Pi Ethernet connection and click Properties. Now double click Internet Protocol version 4. Now select Obtain an IP address automatically and obtain DNS server address automatically. Press OK. Now click Details. Make note of auto configuration IPv4 address in the notepad. In our case, it is 169.254.109.93. Now unmount the card reader from the Raspberry Pi and insert it in the laptop. Navigate to the SD card drive and open the file named cmdline.txt. If you find root weight is not the last word in the file, then remove all preceding the root weight and type the command ip equal to paste the IP which we noted from auto configuration IPv4 address and increment 1 to the last number. In my case, it is 93, so I am making it as 94. Save the file and eject the memory card and remember this IP address. Now we will connect the Raspberry Pi to the monitor directly. You can connect to any display which connects via HDMI. To connect Raspberry Pi to the monitor directly, mount the SD card with Raspbian OS in it in the Raspberry Pi and connect to the power source. Make sure you are inserting the SD card before giving the power source. This is very important. The power light must blink. Next, insert the HDMI cable to the Raspberry Pi. Next, plug in the mouse and the keyboard to the USB port. At least, mouse is mandatory. Now you can see the Raspbian boot screen in the monitor. Since I didn't connect to the keyboard, I installed the on-screen keyboard. Click the Raspberry Pi symbol on the left side top corner, select accessories and select keyboard. Now open terminal, enter the command ifconfig. Here in the eth0 section, we can see the IP address as 169.254.109.94, which we have entered in the command line.txt. Now enter the command sudo space raspi-config. Now this will open a list. Now select 5 interfacing options. Then select T2SSH in this screen. Select S. You will get a message as the SSH server is enabled. Now close the terminal and shut down the Raspbian and unplug it from the monitor and connect it to the laptop. Now open the command prompt and enter the command ping 169.254.109.94. Now this will work fine. Now open PuTTY and load the Raspberry session. Change the host name from raspberrypi.mshome.net to 169.254.109.94. In your case, it might be any IP which you entered in commandline.txt. Now save and click open. Now if you get the PuTTY security alert, that means your Raspberry Pi is connected. Finally, you are done and can be accessible from your laptop. Click yes. Now terminal PuTTY bash will appear with the text login as. Here enter the username pi, P-I and press enter. Then enter the password raspberry, R-A-S-P-B-E-R-R-Y. Now enter the command lx terminal without space between lx and terminal. If you get this error, cannot open, display localhost :10.0, that means Xmin server is not running. Start the Xmin server and make sure you checked enable X11 forwarding in the PuTTY. Now retry the command lx terminal. Now Raspbian terminal will be opened. Now you can close the Raspberry Pi terminal view. Now to view Raspbian OS desktop view, enter the command start lxde without space. This will open the Raspberry Pi desktop view. We will get warning like SSH is enabled and default password raspberry is not changed. You can change it. Click OK. Now this opens the Raspbian OS desktop view. You can close this terminal by pressing Ctrl plus C in the putty bash. If you feel this video helped you, please subscribe to this channel. I will be posting more contents on Raspberry Pi, artificial intelligence, and connecting IoT with artificial intelligence. Thanks for watching this video. Please drop your feedback and queries in the comment section. Press bell icon to get notified when I upload a video.